In this video, we're going to cover the following. What's Strapi and why use it? How to get up and running with Strapi for testing quickly? How to build a quick model for a little guestbook application? And how to use web requests to interact with the API. So let's begin by touching on what Strapi actually is and why you may want to use it. Strapi markets itself as an efficient API creation tool that lets you get your website or application up and running quickly. And I have to agree, my own installations of Strapi are running with very little memory or computational overhead, and they were simple enough for me to get my projects up and running quickly. What you get with Strapi is a helpful admin panel, a framework, some very useful default plugins, and many more plugin contributions from the community. Of course, Strapi is open source, meaning you can extend it to suit your own needs, or even contribute as part of the community. To get up and running, we're going to use Docker, which I hope will allow you to follow along with this video regardless of your host operating system. Depending on how you plan to deploy Strapi, Docker may also come handy. It's also worth mentioning I'm not a DevOps guy, so my selection of Docker is purely out of convenience. Don't expect Docker best practices from this video. If you don't have Docker or don't know how to use it, you can get up and running with Docker in around 5 minutes using one of my videos on learning Docker for Windows, Ubuntu, or macOS. Also, Strapi needs to run on top of a database, and by default, it's configured to use MongoDB. However, for this video, we're going to use MariaDB. This is simply because it's the database I use personally. Let's get started. I've uploaded my Docker Compose file at this public GitHub repository. You can get a copy of it by downloading it as a zip or cloning it through Git. For this video, we're going to clone it using Git. To do so, I'll create a new folder, name it appropriately, and open a terminal at that location. Then, I'm going to type git clone and paste in the repository address. Once I hit enter, it's going to clone the repository into that directory. Before moving on, make sure to go into this folder and open the Docker Compose file in your editor of choice. Then, you want to substitute this directory with a directory on your host machine. This must be shared with Docker. Make sure to check Docker preferences, especially on Windows. Now let's open a terminal window in this directory and create the database and application containers using docker compose up-d. If you have Kitematic installed, you can open it now and check on the logs from both our database and application container. This will give us an indication of when Strapi is ready to go. When Strapi is ready, the logs will print out the location of the admin panel. If you use the port number in my Docker Compose file, you'll want to visit localhost colon 8080 /admin. On your first visit, you'll need to create your administrator account. Now we're inside Strapi's admin panel. From here, you can configure and manage your API fairly easily, and you'll only need to dig deeper into configuration files if you need something extra. You can see a content type already exists, called user, and if we look inside, you can see we have a single entry for the administrator account we just created. But let's move on to creating our own content type. Say we want some kind of old school guestbook like every GeoCities website used to have. We want the user to be able to enter 3 bits of data: their name, some kind of message, and their email. We can do this all through the admin panel, using the default Content Type Builder plugin. We can see the existing content types: user, role, and permission. So let's click Add Content Type in the top right to get started. We need to give our content type a name. Strapi advise that it should be singular, so we'll call it Note, as in guests leaving notes on our web page. Click Save, and now we need to populate it with fields to store the relevant data. Click Add New Field, and you can see the different types of data supported by Strapi, and some examples for their use. Let's use a string for the name of a note leaver. We'll call this field Name. I want this field to be mandatory, but I also want to allow the user to be anonymous. So, I'll quickly go to the Advanced Settings tab, enter a default value of anonymous, and check the box indicating it's a required field. By clicking Add New Field here, I can move straight onto adding the next field. This time, let's use the text type to store the message that's being left. We'll name this Message. I don't want this to be empty again, so I'm going to indicate that it's a required field using the advanced settings. Let's also click Display as a WYSIWYG to enable the nice editor in the Strapi admin panel. We're going to see this later. Finally, let's add one last field to store the note leaver's email address. We'll simply name this Email and mark it as a required field as well. So now that we've finished adding our fields, we can click Continue, and then click Save to save our content type. Now we wait for our Strapi server to restart. When it's done, our content type is ready to view through the admin panel. Click on our new note content type in the navigation panel, and you can see an empty list of notes. You'll notice our three fields plus the ID. If we click Add New Note, we can create our first note through the admin panel. Let's use My Name and leave a message using the Markdown editor we talked about earlier. We'll set an email and click Save. Now you can see our newly created note in this list. Let's quickly add a second one to use in the examples that follow. All done. Now, let's interact with our API and content type using web requests. We're going to do this first using a web browser. If we make a GET request to our Strapi installation followed by our content type, it should return a list of all of our note items in the JSON format. However, you can see we don't yet have permission to do this. Let's have a quick glance at the permissions in Strapi. Back in the admin panel, if you click the Roles and Permissions plugin, we can see three different default roles: Administrator, Authenticated, and Public. We're not going to go too deep into roles and permissions for this video, so let's simply expose all of our actions publicly. This is only for the purpose of demonstration and not advised. Click on Public and scroll down to see the permissions granted per action. We're going to check Select All and save everything up. With this done, let's try our GET request one more time. Perfect. Now we're receiving the JSON for both of the notes we created through the admin panel. This has been formatted nicely through Firefox, but here is the raw JSON just to show you what to expect. Now that we've interacted with Strapi using the web browser, let's move on to creating notes using post requests. I'm going to use an app called Postman to do this. We can use it to configure and execute requests to test our API. It's available for Windows, macOS, and Linux, but you're welcome to use any software of your own choice. With Postman open, we can make a quick GET request to check if it's working as expected. We'll select GET from the dropdown, copy in our API location, and hit Send. It appears to be working as expected, and we can see the two entries from earlier. Now, let's try creating a note. This time, we'll select Post from the drop-down and paste in our location once again. We're going to configure our request body using raw JSON, and then type in the JSON we'd like to post. Here you can see I'm setting the name, the message, and the email. Once it's done, click Send. And there we have it. We can check this by sending our earlier GET request once again. As expected, we now see three note items returned from Strapi. Lastly, let's try and delete this note here with the ID 2. To do this, create a new request and select Delete from the dropdown this time. We're going to enter our location and also pass in the ID of 2 to delete the second note left by the anonymous guest. Click Send, and we're done. Let's check this again using our earlier GET request. Great, we can see that it worked. The notes with the ID 1 and 3 have been returned, but the note with the ID 2 has been deleted. I hope you found this useful. I've personally used Strapi in a few projects now, and I think it's an excellent solution. You can watch my other videos on Docker or even on artificial intelligence topics for beginners on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to be notified of the next Strapi video, in which I'll be digging deeper into creating your own actions outside of a default Strapi behavior. I will also be releasing a video on how to communicate with Strapi through Unity 3D, allowing you to build things like leaderboards, uploading and sharing stage designs, and much more.